Hello, Bull Rider fans, and welcome to When the Dust Settles. I am Z-Man, your host, and we are going to recap the Stanley Tools and Security Invitational that just happened in Billings, Montana. First of all, I just want to say we are back in my home studio here in Massachusetts. I want to thank the PBR for three incredible nights over at in Mohegan Sun for the Mohegan Sun Invitational, which was last weekend. Thank you to PBR for letting me cover that. It was absolutely incredible, and it was a great time. Got to meet some great guys and got to talk with them also. Lachlan Richardson, the young bull rider out of Australia, is the one that actually won that event. And we're going to be talking about him this week. You people are probably wondering what happened to him. Some of you probably saw it this past weekend, but I'm going to recap it right here on When the Dust Settles. Also, J.P. Mooney running on his offhand. Big news. It was his first week in Mohegan Sun. Big news coming from Mohegan Sun, him doing it. Didn't fare too well. How did he do in Billings? Well, if you missed it this weekend, I'm going to show it to you right here on When the Dust Settles also. Also, I just want to say the top five was got a little bumped around after the Mohegan Sun Invitational. I mean, J.P. Mooney slipped from second to fourth. Silvano Alves moved up to the second spot. So your 2011 PBR World Champion, who was trying to be the first bull rider, professional bull rider in the PBR, to get the number one spot and to get that World Championship 2 years in a row, is really making a run for Valderon de Oliveira. Valderon, who did not show up to Billings, Montana, and you're seeing it right here. The main event he was on last week in Connecticut, landed on top of him. Final round, completed ride, main event, ended up landing on top of him. He was out in Billings. He has to get some surgery done on his eye socket, and he has a concussion. Valderon says he will be at the Idaho Invitational in Idaho. The Boise Invitational in Boise, Idaho. He says he will be there. Real quickly, 15-15 bucking battle happened this past weekend. A lot of bulls were ridden. It was kind of surprising. A lot of bulls were ridden. There was a lot of ranked bulls there, but you know something? These guys are starting to ride these ranked bulls, and it was good to see. Real quickly, I already talked about Valderon de Oliveira and his injury. Ryan Dirt Eater out with a concussion. Again, did not show up to Billings. He didn't go the last round over in Connecticut at Mohegan Sun Invitational. He had the concussion. I spoke to him prior to the event. Said he had a concussion. He did all right in the 15-15 bucking battle. He wasn't going to chance it anymore. He was going to sit out the final round over at Connecticut, the Mohegan Sun Invitational. Did not make it to Billings, Montana for the Stanley Tools and Security Invitational. Ended up not making it there. He's still out with that concussion. Funny thing is, the same bull that knocked Valderon de Oliveira out in the final round of day three was the same bull that knocked out Ryan Dirt Eater a day prior. Interesting. Douglas Duncan did not make it to Billings. Douglas Duncan got his hip surgery done, and he is recovering from hip surgery. I got a tweet from Douglas Duncan, and he stated that everything went well. He is recovering from his hip surgery. So, real quickly, let's get into day one. Day one, on YouTube. For you people that have YouTube, it was on YouTube. Day one of in Billings, but it was the Stanley Tools and Security Invitational. Lachlan Richardson gets bucked off his first bull he faces. Unfortunate. Welcome to the PBR. You know, you go perfect. You know, 4-for-4 in Connecticut. Well, you get bucked off your first one here. It happens. You know, it's a long season. Cody Loster ends up winning day one in Billings with this winning ride right here. You're seeing it. And he scores an 89 points on the back of Prince Albert. Wow. 89 points.
You can say that again.
Ben Jones comes to Billings. Ben Jones actually does not do too bad in Billings. Ben Jones rides his first bull dirty deeds for 65 points. The bull wasn't all that great. Ben Jones, you know, stayed on the bull. He kept it going with it. Bull wasn't all that great. You know something? Ben Jones traveling with Guilherme Machi and hanging out with the Brazilians. He states that Savano Alves told him, look, you got a ride in the bag. Just keep it. Don't go for your re-ride. He gets the 65 points. Doesn't go for the re-ride. Keeps the 65 points. So he has the one in the bag. So he ends up keeping it. The beginning of the day two, you would see it on TV, on CBS. Actually, it was the night of day one. The 15-15 bucking battle, I'm just going to let you know. It actually happens. It's a short. It happens at the night of the first round. You see it on TV as being that day. TV says that it happened that earlier that day. But it actually happens in the first round. So if you're going to an event, a PBR event, and there's a 15-15 bucking battle, you'll want to go the first day. That's when you're going to see the 15-15 bucking battle. You're not going to see it earlier that afternoon. You're going to see it day one. So you people that don't actually follow it online or, you know, whatever, you're not going to see it. You actually won't see it online. They cut it out because they want you to watch it on TV. But it is that first day. The 15-15 bucking battle happens that later on that day. You just see it that afternoon and on TV. Well, 15-15 bucking battle looked like this. Your 15th bull rider was Cody Lostro, and he ended up on the back of Mac Nett's Southern Wine. Hav Stewart on the back of Straight Jacket. Robson Palermo was on the back of David's Dream. Stormy Wing on the back of Red River. Luke Snyder on the back of Carrillo Cartel. Caleb Sanderson had Great White. Justin Kuhn, Cooper Tires, Grey Ghost. Fabiano Vieira, Party All the Time. Renato Nunes on the back of Bucky. Austin Meyer would have to face SmackDown. Six straight buck-offs SmackDown has right now. Guilherme Machi on the back of Pandemic. Marco Gucci has Chocolate Thunder. J.P. Mooney, R.M.E.F., Gunpowder, and Lead. This is their third time meeting up. J.P. Mooney has won the last two times. L.J. Jenkins would be on the back of Unser's Racing Bull. This is a rematch from earlier in the year. L.J. Jenkins was in a PRCA event, and he actually won on the back of this bull. Silvano Alves was not won the event, but he won the matchup. Silvano Alves was on the back of Cowboy Casanova. Like I said, some of these bull riders are like, what? What are they? Injuries, you know, due to injuries, Valderon was out and everything. But let's get into the rides. Number 15, Cody Lostro on the back of MacNet Southern Wine. 4.17 seconds. MacNet Southern Wine bucks him off. Goes to Hav Stewart. Hav Stewart's in the back of Straight Jacket. 5.28 seconds. This was a rematch between these two. The bull wins the rematch. Robson Palermo, there's a story behind this. Robson Palermo, Guilherme Machi, they were using borrowed equipment. The airlines that they used lost their luggage, and they had to use borrowed equipment for the first day. Robson Palermo was on the back of David's Dream. We all know the story behind David's Dream. 1.77 seconds, he gets bucked off, re-injures that shoulder that he had surgically fixed, that he was out for earlier in the year. Re-injures the shoulder. Interesting. Stormy Wing on the back of Red River. 2.10 seconds he would get bucked off. Luke Snyder, who was in, he's in a slump, you know. Carrillo Cartel, 5.41 seconds. And later on, I'm gonna tell you, I think I got his slump. The actual numbers, how many times he's gotten bucked off. I mean, you know, how long it's been since he's ridden the bull. I think he's got something like, I want to say, 17 straight buck offs or something. That he's in a real, you know, he's in a real slump. coming into this event. But anyway, he was on the back of Creole Cartel, 5.41 seconds. Caleb Sanderson on the back of Great White, 2.93 seconds. Just really, right quick, want to go back to Luke Snyder. Luke Snyder is one heck of a bull rider. And you know something? He later on in the weekend, he got out of it. He ended up riding the bull. Really, you know, it was just, I think it was pride, and it was the show that guys on the TV were talking about the helmet, and it was just showing that, I think he wanted to prove that the helmet really doesn't have much to do with his slump, and he's not making any excuses about why he's slumping. Caleb, like I said, Caleb Sanderson on the back of Great White, 2.93 seconds gets bucked off. Justin Kuhn on the back of Cooper Tires Gray Ghost, 2.98 seconds. He gets bucked off. Fabiano Vieira. I want to get to him real quick. Fabiano Vieira on the back of Party All the Time. Fabiano Vieira is on the other side of the spectrum from Luke Snyder. Fabiano Vieira is actually, I think, out of 17, his last 17 rides, he's ridden, I think, 13 or 15 bulls. So he's actually on an upswing. First ride of the 15-15 bucking battle, 88 and a quarter points. He gets on the back of Party All the Time. Renato Nunes on the back of Bucky. Bucky, one of those top-ranked bulls. You know, you got to put him in the area of SmackDown, Asteroid, Bushwhacker. Bucky's one of those bulls. 5.50 seconds bucks off Renato Nunes. Austin Meyer, talk about SmackDown. SmackDown, six straight buck-offs. Austin Meyer has them. Austin Meyer, 4.13 seconds. SmackDown's seven straight buck-offs. Glamry Machi on the back of Pandemic. Glamry Machi would ride Pandemic. You're seeing the ride. 90 points. Marco Aguche on the back of Chalk of Thunder. He gets bucked off. 2.32 seconds. Then you go down to J.P. Mooney versus Gun RMEF, Gunpowder and Lead. This is the third time these two have met up. J.P. Mooney has won the last two events they met up. You're looking at the ride, people. Unbelievable. He ends up getting underneath the bull. You see how the bull kicks around him. He gets out of there. Good work with the bullfighters. And 89 points he gets on the back of him. He's ridden that bull now a perfect three times. And I'm going to tell you what, it has to get your confidence up. Congratulations, J.P. Mooney. Good to see. L.J. Jenkins on the back of Unser Racing Bull. Told you, he already met this bull once in a PRCA event. He's beaten the bull before. Well, it didn't change. 85 points he gets on the back of Unser Racing Bull. And then you will go down. So your number two bull rider in the world, Silvano Alves,